place to catch up with friends, relax in a friendly atmosphere and enjoy great service and food, then Buckley's can offer a fun evening that the whole family can enjoy. In our bistro, you can enjoy a selection from our extensive menu, including family favourites. On those sunny days, our alfresco is the perfect setting to enjoy a meal, catch up with friends, or watch your favourite sport on two large plasma TVs. Having a special occasion can be made easy by hiring our newly renovated function rooms. Buckley's, a venue of class that provides all your entertainment and function needs.
Welcome back, yes, and the frivolity continues on air as they keep on bagging the North Shore Football Club. I won't have any part of that because we don't discuss individual clubs here. Once again, of course, it's the time for that very popular segment, Dale's Under 18th segment, and we'll find out exactly how Doodle's going. How are you going, Dale? Go.
I'm going all right, Dick. You know, there's one side of North Shore that is performing pretty well. They kicked 22 goals, 840 to defeat Inverleigh, one goal, 410, and Inverleigh a fifth. But four or five players out with flu, but I don't think it would have made the other 130-point difference.
Didn't have any trouble with the timekeepers in that game, obviously.
No, obviously not, but the only trouble they had was getting the ball back over the railway line. King will kick seven, McGinchy three, Parker, Riccardi and Lansbury Lowe all with two. Better players, Anderson, Kingwall and Lansbury Lowe. The sole goal kicker for Inverleigh was Alford. Better players out there was Pekin, Brown and Brackley. Werribee Centrals defeated East Geelong, and this was maybe 3-4, I think. So it was 10-3-63. They defeated East Geelong 5-3-33. Goals for Werribee, Davis and Steele both with two. Best players, Vasiljevic, Davis and Blade were their better players. East Geelong had five individual goal kickers, but their better players, Bowman, and he's a name that's getting in there Ringsley now, with Soldani and Kingsley. And Belpost Hill recorded their second win of the year, Dick, so that was a good win over the Belmont Lions, who were up there. I think they were pretty high up as well. So Belpost Hill 10-9-69 defeated Belmont Lions 7-13-55. Sorry, 10-9-69. Did I say that? No, maybe I didn't. Anyway, doesn't matter.
Dick's not even listening to you. What's
goals? Isaac got three. Martin and Stringer both with two. Best players, Symes, B, Martinu and Cossa. For the Lions, goals to Williams, three, and Matthews, two. Better players, Martin, Donnell and Boyd. Bannockburn, 9-8-62 defeated Corio 7-8-50. Goal kickers there, LeMate 4, O'Brien 2. Better players, LeMate, Knight and Lucas.
Your mate?
LeMate.
Oh, LeMate, here. Yeah.
Thank you.
He's a
and goals,
French friend.
It is, you're right. And goals for Corio, Hunter 4, the three out individual goal kickers. Better players, D. Burke, Groot and C. Burke. So the two Burke boys in there again, that's good work for them. And Thompson Tigers, without Doodle, 9-10-64. Defeated Winchelsea, 4-1-25.
That will doodle free.
Bizanella, 3. Hodgson and Riley, 2. Better players, Hodgson and Whitworth. And for the Winchelsea side, Palakis kicked 2. Carroll and Budavalis, 1 each. Better players, Carroll, Shepherd and Dennis. So North Geelong, well astern, top of the ladder. Won't change. They'll win it. Put their name on it now, Dick.
So Thompson are okay even without the doodle.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We'll leave that alone as well. Well, this afternoon it is on again. It is a absolutely fantastic game. It may be a preview of this year's grand final. It's top versus second. It's out at the Ringraid Recreation Reserve. It is the 94.7 match of the round, and rightfully so. As you say, first versus second. The Belpost Hill Panthers, they take on the Thompson Tigers, the Violet Crumbles, and they're back in town again. They're on their way trying to defend their flag from 2008. And, of course, they're playing very good football at the moment. Dale, you must be excited. Well, also excited about this game as well.
I'm certainly excited, Dick, about this game of football. And let's hope it has something like the game we saw earlier in the season. And possibly, I won't say 100%, but there could be some important inclusions into both sides. We think Damien Vassalou might front up for the Belpost Hill side, and don't be too far away that Tom Harriott might take his place in the Thompson side.
Ooh. Ooh. There you go. I told
he played
you.
In the seconds on the weekend, I'll be sold. And I think they're just working him into the field to be coming into final. So there could be two important players. Vassalou, especially for the Belpost Hill side, will just strengthen their midfield. They've got plenty of tools up forward kicking goals. Venner's going forward kicking goals. Justin Tarr's performing pretty well. I just think Belpost still aren't doing too much wrong, and I just think they're going to win at home and will cement their position well and truly at top of the ladder.
Jake, we've mentioned earlier in the shows before that the big guns of Thompson Footy Club are coming back to the fore again. And we speak of, obviously, the Tommy Harris. We speak of the Christian Highlands, the Sabali Armstrongs, the McLeod dynasty, obviously,
yep,
kicking goal week after week. It's the signs can be a bit ominous that they are on their way back to a big finals campaign again.
Yeah, look, I think it's something we've noticed all year. They've obviously just sort of been plodding along. They've also been up the top of the ladder for most of the year. And even though they've been up there, most of us couldn't help but think that they've still got an extra gear to go to. And I suppose it's a very good position to be in. I've noticed that, you know, Jackson McLeod obviously had a few injury worries earlier in the season, and he's just slowly starting to get back into good form. He's slowly climbing that goal-kicking tree. And we all know that on his day, he's probably one of the better forwards in the league. So Thompson are probably just starting to get in that shape that they want to be. I'm pretty sure that they'll cop a loss this week because, I don't know, as Dale said, Belpost Hill have just been phenomenal over the last few weeks, and they absolutely spanked Belmont, who are absolutely, you know, they're no monkeys in the competition. They're one of those medium range sides, and you'd have to say at home that Belpost Hill will be far too strong. We saw last time fitness was one of the issues. It was probably the biggest factor on the day in round two. I think Thompson were up by about 3 goals at three quarter time, and they had the breeze in the last quarter. But Belpost Hill were just able to keep the ball down there into the ground, and they ended up getting up, I think, with one of the last kicks of the day. So if Belpost Hill could win then, it's obvious that both sides have come along in leaps and bounds since then, but I'd have to say that Belpost Hill get the job done today.
Jason, you've been around local footy a long time. Belpost Hill haven't won a flag in the GDFL. Being on top at the moment, that's all right to mention that.
Yeah.
They haven't won a flag. They're on top. And, of course, the old nemesis Thompson's in there. If they can beat Thompson today, it must give them a lot of confidence.
I think so. Firstly, I'd like an apology from the rest of the media team because they laughed at me 3 weeks ago when I said Tom Harriet was going to play for Thompson again. Dale said he was on a golf course. He's back. I told you that, didn't I? Yeah, nobody listens to me. It's okay. That's all right. I actually think Thompson will win this afternoon. And I know people will think that I'm on a Belpost Hill basher, but I actually think
that... Suck up to Thompson, too.
No, I don't suck up to Thompson.
You do.
I've got a life membership there, but that's beside the point. I just think that their structure... Like, they should have won against Belpost Hill in the season, and they did run out of legs. I think they'll want to win. I think that they need to win. I think that they have probably been just going through the motions a bit in the last few weeks. I think it'll be close. I think it'll be a very close game. I think if Vassalou does play... and plays well, he could be the difference, but I just think that Thompson might just get over the line.
Unbelievable. I don't know why, but I knew you'd say that. We're going to take a short break when we come back. There's 5 more games to talk about back after this.
The place to catch up with friends, relax in a friendly atmosphere and enjoy great service and food. Then Buckley's can offer a fun evening that the whole family can enjoy. In our bistro, you can enjoy a selection from our extensive menu, including family favourites. On those sunny days, our alfresco is the perfect setting to enjoy a meal, catch up with friends, or watch your favourite sport on 2 large plasma TVs. Having a special occasion can be made easy by hiring our newly renovated function rooms. Buckley's, a venue of class that provides all your entertainment and function needs.